Book Can Anybody Help Me? I got the idea when I was on maternity leave with my first child because I started using a lot of parenting websites. I think most people, when they have a baby, or actually if they have any question these days, they go on Google and they try and find out, you know, they ask people all over the world, can you help me with this question? And people, when they get pregnant and when they have babies, go on these parenting sites and they end up speaking to other women around the country or indeed around the world. And a lot of them use fake names. They think they're anonymous and they give very deep details about themselves and their lives to complete strangers because they feel that it's a safe space to talk about. So I started using these websites like every other new mother, asking questions about feeds and sleep and everything else. And then at one stage on an Irish website, I realised I recognised another woman on the site from real life because of some of the information she'd given about where she was from and the age of her child and so on. And I suddenly started to think, gosh, this would be very easy to actually track somebody down if you knew them or if you wanted to find out what they were doing. And I almost felt as if I was reading somebody's diary because I knew who she was, but obviously she didn't know who I was. So this got me thinking, and I'm a journalist, so I'm probably automatically quite suspicious anyway about information and about giving too much information. And I started to think, what if you recognise somebody on a website and you weren't friendly with them and you didn't want to be particularly nice to them? And that's where the germ of the idea came. So the book is called Can Anybody Help Me?, which is a phrase that a lot of these women use on these sites, but obviously in this case, because it is a thriller, it has a slightly more nefarious meaning. So the book is set in Dublin, but one of the main characters is a woman who has come from London to Dublin to live, and that's quite significant because she's a first-time mother. She marries an Irish man, she falls pregnant fairly quickly, so a lot of things happen to her very quickly. She has to leave her country, she has to come to a new country, she's expecting a baby, she has a baby, he has a new job, so she ends up very isolated and very lonely in Dublin. So even though Dublin, a lot of people think of it as a very friendly place, and it can be, if you're sitting at home with a brand new baby, it can be quite hard to go out and meet people. So she starts to use this website a lot and finds that a lot of her friends are online, and because she's quite sensitive or quite a shy person, she finds it easier to talk to people online than she does to talk to people in the real world. So the other main character in the book is a policewoman, a guard, and she's a detective sergeant called Claire, and she's also expecting her first child. But even though she's 6 months pregnant, she doesn't want to let this slow her down at all. She's dealing with her very first murder inquiry and she's completely gung-ho. She's very energetic and she wants to solve the crime. So she is a very Irish person. I think she's originally from the west of Ireland and is now living in Dublin. And that's a specific type of person who, you know, has moved to a big city and I suppose has certain attitudes about that. So I would say, yes, it is specifically set in Dublin. A lot of the language is quite colloquial, but at the same time, because so much of it is set online or set in cyberspace, there's a kind of a universality to it as well that I think a lot of people will enjoy. And I have found that I've had readers, you know, talk to me from Britain, from America, from Australia, because these websites are all over the place and even the language the women use is the same. So I found that very interesting. So Can Anybody Help Me was my first novel, and I suppose like all first novels, it evolved. It was originally about this woman, Yvonne, who moved from London to Dublin. But then I started writing this police character called Claire, and she grew and grew as a character. So when I was halfway through writing it, my agent said, do you think this could be a series? That she herself is an interesting character. And I thought, I hadn't actually thought of that, but yes, I think she could be. So I was really delighted with how the first novel went. It was shortlisted for the Crime Book of the Year Awards in the Bord Gáis Energy Irish Book Awards last year, and it got into the bestseller list here in Ireland and it got some very good reviews. So I then wrote another book, so my second book will be out in July, and it'll be out in English in July in this country, and it also features Sergeant Claire Boyle, and now she's back to work with a small baby, so there are even more difficulties for her. So I'm really thrilled. What started off as one small idea has now turned into a series, and there will be at least three books in the series. So we're here at the Franco-Irish Literary Festival, which this year is about crime fiction. And I was really delighted to be invited because I love reading crime fiction, but I also love reading crime fiction in translation. And a lot of people in Ireland are reading Scandinavian fiction at the moment, which I find fascinating. But I've also read some French books. I have to excuse my pronunciation, but the likes of Pierre Lemaitre and Fred Vargas, for example, would be read over here in English. And I really love reading translated crime because it gives you such an insight into a society society and into a way of thinking. And I think crime, because it has such a specific structure, makes it quite easy to learn about another country's customs. So absolutely delighted to be here. I haven't read many of the authors that are actually appearing here today, but I'm really hoping there's a bookshop downstairs, so I'm certainly hoping to pick up some of their books and bring them home with me.